We are about to embark upon a series of strange and exciting, dangerous adventures. Adventures that will lead us to all parts of the world.
Hello and welcome to another Bad Comic Review. This time we're looking at Powers of X issue 3 of 6, published by Marvel Comics in 2019. This is written by Jonathan Hickman, art by R.B. Silva, Marte Garcia was the color artist, VC's Clayton Cowles was the letterer, Tom Muller design, R.B. Silva and Marte Garcia did the cover art, which is actually a pretty cool pinup style cover. The Sentinel looks awesome. Assistant editor was Annalise Bisa, Jordan D. White editor, C.B. Spolsky editor-in-chief. Alright, so this issue actually has some payoff. Apocalypse, Wolverine, and Krakoa, or whatever the plant guy, swamp thing looking dude's name is, are trying to get into a mainframe to retrieve some important information, while the others are up top causing a distraction. Things go pretty horribly wrong for everybody in this one. Nimrod catches on to what they're doing, he goes down to stop them, and Apocalypse and him duke it out. It's a pretty cool fight sequence, pretty well done, and we have a real interesting twist ending that I kind of saw coming based on some of the hints they left earlier, but it was a cool way to end the issue, and it definitely changes things quite a bit. All in all, this was a solid issue, and I would definitely recommend it. My problem with it is that the white pages are still here, and they clutter up the book considerably. I see what they're trying to do with it to give it kind of this computer look to it, but it really takes up a lot of extra pages and gives you very little. They could have shrunk it down to one or two pages. Instead, it takes up a good six pages in the book, and that's what's inflating the cover price from $4 to $5. It makes it look like a cash grab, and it makes it look like they're padding for the trade. I don't like that. I don't like being ripped off, and Marvel has a pretty good track record of trying to get me to buy stuff for an inflated price that I don't need and don't really care about, and it's usually low-end garbage. This is actually really well written, and it really does tie things into House of X. You need to read this issue before House of X issue 3. It'll make a lot more sense, and story-wise, that's the progression they want you to take. There are some qualms I take with the art, but overall it looked pretty good. The androids looked really cool. Apocalypse looked really cool. Nimrod looked great. The backgrounds were fantastic, and the story itself was pretty solid. So this is actually going to go somewhere, it looks like. It doesn't look like they're just leading us on. So I'm interested to see where House of X issue 3 goes and where the fourth issue of this one goes. So this is a definite recommend, but you're going to have to read the first issues and House of X issues before this in order to get anything out of this. As a standalone book, it is terrible. There's a couple of cool fight scenes, but none of it's going to make any sense. So you're definitely going to have to read both miniseries for this to make a cohesive story. Still going to recommend it, but that's just my opinion. As always, thank you so much for watching and supporting the channel. If you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss future reviews. If you want to help the channel in other ways, links are in the description and on the about page. And as always, we hope to see you on the next one.